Alright guys, I hope all of you are doing well. So please do subscribe my channel and watch the video till the end. I am having couple of fitness updates. So let's get started. The first update is coming from Derek Lunsford, who is currently Mr. Olympia. But now he is 7 weeks out of Mr. Olympia 2024 and he's focusing on his back. So dedicatedly look at the comments he's getting. Yoni is saying all is nothing and Chris Bumstead is saying let's go bro is hungry. So he is focusing so much and I hope he is going to chase this title again. The second update is coming from Samson Doda. He is looking awesome. He is reminding us of Mr. Rolling Coleman. Look at his back and his glutes, everything is looking so amazing. His calf, he is also working on his back, which he thinks it is the most weakest point of him. But now he is 7 weeks out of Mr. Olympia and he has won Mr. Arnold Classic UK. So this guy is going to chase the title again, I think, in Mr. Olympia. So it would be a tough fight between all the pro card winners. And look at his glutes, his hamstrings, his calves, he's looking amazing guys. And look at the side chest. So I think Samson Doda is a person who is going to hit the title if he can and land. The third update is coming from, if you can see, the Hunter Labrada is looking amazing. From the last so many competitions, we thought that he is not going to be a big fighter in Mr. Olympia. But now if you look at his conditioning, he is looking amazing guy. All the veins are coming so out from the skin that you can see the paper thin skin. The third update we are gonna have is from Keone Pearson. He is consistently focusing on his back and he's the person who is regularly uploading his workout videos, always helped out by his wife. So that's a great thing. The couple is having a mission that Keone should focus on his 212 title, and if possible he is going to retain his 212 championship category against big threat like Sean Cole Florida. So Keone is following the footsteps of, I think you can say, the Derek Lunsford, because Derek was a 212 championship in 2021 and now he's playing in open bodybuilding category. So Keone is also a bodybuilder who is focusing on his all the parts, and consistently you can see he is improving all of his body parts. So let's hope that Keone would be also a Mr. Olympia champion in the forthcoming years. But one thing is there, that this guy is so cool and he never hates against anyone. The other update is coming from a big bodybuilder. You can see him off that he is focusing on his shoulder and making muscle mind connection. This type of modern machine is making so much convenience to the modern bodybuilders to develop each and every part like delts, shoulder, and you can see the back machines also. Gone are the days when we do not have these kinds of machine, but look at the workout that this guy is sharing. That's an amazing thing. The next thing I'm going to sharing, the next update I'm going to tell you about from a guruji of bodybuilding who is from India. And what is he saying, I'm going to translate into the English. So please enjoy my video and do not skip any part of it. So now I'm going to tell you that what is he saying, what good tips is giving to you. Guruji means our respected coach. He is saying that always tie belt if you are ready for squats. If you are under the bar, never go without belt. Number two, bring both foot forward towards the bar. Bring both foot forward. Don't bring one foot because it will distribute your load. And number three, your foot stance should be always equal to shoulder width if you are doing bodybuilding. And if your goal is powerlifting, you your stance should be little bit wider than your shoulder width. Though both things are separate, so please take it and seriously and do the same as he is recommending. And number four mistakes, that if you are doing everything right and you lifted it, but if you are doing half squats, that's a wrong thing because it will not give you benefit. There is a risk of getting injured, so always do deep squats. If possible, do it with lighter weights. Now he is saying that you have done everything right, you lifted off the bar in a right position on right time, but if you are bending your back forward, then that's a main reason for the injury. So try to be stable, straight, and try to remain in a straight position if you are lifting off the bar towards upwards. So now he is saying that if you are bending your back, and then it can cause a lot of injury. And now he is recommending the right way. Now he is telling the right way that you should do like this. He is showing all the proper form and how you should do exercise according to your capacity, and you should lift up the weight according to your body capacity, because the more reps you can do with lighter weights, that can also give you the right benefit. But if you are an advanced bodybuilder or advanced athlete, you can do 6 to 8 reps with heavy weight also. That will be very good for size. So please follow my videos and like my channel. I'm saying that please like my video and subscribe my channel, and I will bring more and more videos like this. Please excuse my average English, but I am trying to give you good knowledge.